Hi everybody, today we will be talking about lesson 109, dividing a decimal number by a whole number. Okay, so we have talked about what to do with a decimal when we are adding or when we are subtracting. And when we do those, we line up the decimal. So if I had 1.6, 12.4, 0.98, okay, we make sure the decimals are in a nice straight line. When we multiply decimals, we do our regular multiplication, and then we count the number of decimals in order to place our decimal. With division, you move the decimal straight up. So let's look at example one. For an art project, Corbin must cut a length of ribbon in half. The ribbon is 4.8 meters long. If he cuts the ribbon correctly, how long will each length of ribbon be? So our problem is 4.8 divided by 2. We are dividing in half. So we're going to take this decimal before we do anything else, and we're going to move it straight up. And then we ignore it. And now we divide like normal. So 2 goes into 4 twice. 2 times 2 is 4. We subtract. We bring down. 8 goes into 2 4 times. 4 times 2 is 8. We subtract. And we are finished. So the answer is 2.4 meters. Okay, notice when I divided, I did not bring the decimal down. I didn't do anything with the decimal. I brought the decimal straight up into my answer, and then I left it alone. Okay, let's look at another example. Okay, example two. 0.42 divided by 3. Now, they have the zero here, and you can just bring that decimal straight up, okay, up there, okay, that's fine. I'm taking the zero out. You don't necessarily need it, but I am going to bring my decimal straight up, and now I leave it alone, and I divide. 3 goes into 4 once, and I make sure that my 1 is directly over the 4. It's very important that you line these up. Okay, 1 times 3 is 3. I subtract. I bring down. 3 goes into 12 4 times. 4 times 3 is 12. So my answer then is 0.14 or 0.14. Okay, again, I don't do anything with my decimal down here in the problem. I just move my decimal straight up and then divide like normal. All right, example three. 0.15 divided by 3. Whenever we see a division problem written horizontally, we're going to rewrite it so that it's vertical. 0.15 divided by 3. This time I'm going to leave the zero in there just so that you can see how that works. Okay, so I move my decimal straight up. And now 3 does not go into 0, 3 doesn't go into 1, 3 does go into 15, and 3 goes into 15 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15, and I'm finished, except not really. Now, notice that when I divided, 3 went into 15 hundredths, so the 5 went above the 5 in the 15 hundredths, leaving a space above the tenths. I can't, because there is a decimal here, I can't leave this as 5/10 or half. I have to put a zero in my, where'd it go? As my placeholder above the one. So my answer is 0.05 or 5/100. So you need to, this is why it's very important that you line up your numbers in your problem. If there's a number above the hundredths place, there needs to be a number above the tenths place. If there isn't one, put in a zero. Okay, let's try another one with example four. Okay, divide 0.0024 divided by 3. Okay, we start by taking the decimal straight up. Now, I can go, I know 3 doesn't go into 0, doesn't go into 0, doesn't go into 2, goes into 24, and I can just put my 8 here. The other option is 3 goes into 0, 0 times. I multiply, I bring down, 3 goes into 0, 0 times. Again, I multiply, I subtract, I bring down, 3 goes into 2, 0 times, multiply, subtract, finally bring down the 4, and 3 goes into 24, 8 times. Okay, so this was the long way to do it, by bringing down all of the zeros. Okay, the short way is to write your problem and say, I bring up my decimal, 3 doesn't go into 0, doesn't go into 0, doesn't go into 2, goes into 24 8 times, write the 8 up above, and then just put in placeholder zeros. Okay, same answer, whichever is easiest for you. If you need to write it out the long way, that's fine too. Okay, all right, let's look at example 5. Okay, here we have 24.55 divided by 5. Okay, we take that decimal straight up, and then we leave the decimal alone. So 5 doesn't go into 2, but 5 goes into 24 4 times. 4 times 5 is 20. We subtract, we bring down. 5 goes into 45 9 times. 4 times 5 is, or 9 times 5 is 45. Sorry, 5. We subtract, we bring down. 5 goes into 5 once. Multiply. Whoa. Subtract, just kidding. Okay, and we end up with 4.91. Okay? So again, it doesn't matter where I start to divide, I just bring the decimal straight up, and then I ignore the decimal for the rest of the problem. All right, you have lesson practice A through N, and I will see you in the morning.